H-O-B, Bird Gang, the Hall for the music shit. We's running around together, doing what we do, you know. Painting the town red, you know what that mean and all that. We do banging the beat game, I'm talking about. Say, you know, blood is progress, you know what I'm saying? I went to the whole scale, and I came back home, he just snatched me. Yeah, his position was really
what's good, y'all? What's the numbers TV? It's your boy, Poe Rowe. Make sure you subscribe to the channel if you're not subscribed already. And like a video if you appreciate the content that Poe Rowe was the numbers I provided. Say we back with another profile piece. This one is on Mel Murder, real name Jamel Jones. In this video, we're going to take a look at Melly's life as a high-ranking New York City Blood gang member, his close ties to the music industry with Dipset's Jim Jones, his short-lived time as a rap artist, and also his role in the whole Tekashi 6ix9ine and Treyway situation. Mel Murder's from Bed-Stuy, Brooklyn, and he's been on the scene for a long time. A high-ranking Blood member and close friend and confidant of Dipset rapper Jim Jones, dating back to their early days at the Tunnel nightclub, Melly would be around as muscle during the early years of Jim's rap career. But in 2004, Melly would start rapping here and there after hearing a beat he liked while in the studio. A few years later, he would step from behind the scenes to the forefront once Jones started his Bird Gang record label. Mel, along with Max B and Stack Bundles, would be the faces of the crew and were heavily featured on the MOB Members of Bird Gang mixtape that dropped in 2008 and is looked at as a street classic. In an attempt to be more marketable, Melly would go by the rap name of Mel Matrix whenever he released music through the years. But for some reason, being a full-fledged rapper was never something Melly looked too interested in being. He always looked more comfortable being behind the scenes holding Jim Jones down or back home in his Brooklyn neighborhood. It was there that Melly was a big deal, being one of, if not the highest ranking non-trade blood on the streets of New York City. He would control the set for years, with Bed-Stuy being one of their strongholds. Bird Gang would lose a lot of steam as a movement when Stack Bundles died and Max B left the label after him and Jim Jones had a falling out. In the years following, he would still get the occasional freestyle or interview by Melly, but he never released a full solo project, and over time started to return to his behind-the-scenes position in Jim Jones' entourage that allowed him to stay under the radar and be a shot caller for the non-trade blood set. With no social media of his own, from time to time we would see an occasional video or pic of someone posting him on Instagram or YouTube, but for the most part, Melly was out of the industry light, but still a big factor in his Brooklyn neighborhood. But something would happen in October 2017 that would have Mel Murder return from the shadows. A Mexican rapper with rainbow hair by the name of Tekashi 6ix9ine will release a video for a song called Gunmo. The video was filmed in the same Bed-Stuy neighborhood that Mel Murder ran for years. In fact, 6ix9ine would have a bunch of Mel Murder's little homies in the video flamed up with red bandanas on. The video will blow up, and in a matter of months, the non-trade bloods were the hottest topic in the city once again. But this time it was because of the rainbow-haired rapper who was claiming to be a member, all while trolling any and everybody on the internet. Shoddy, a high-ranking non-trade member, and Melly Loyalist, was around 6ix9ine every day, providing protection, as 6ix9ine would make a new enemy every day, it seemed. 6ix9ine would start screaming Treyway in every song and interview, showing his allegiance to the non-trade bloods. Shoddy would also start becoming popular in the New York City hip-hop scene due to his close relationship with the rapper. In an attempt to add some validation to Tekashi's street cred, Shoddy would start to bring Melly around 6ix9ine at certain video shoots for photo ops to go on blog sites and their own Instagram pages. Incidents involving Tekashi and the Treyway camp would start to happen back to back, ranging from something as minor as an Instagram beef to something as serious as a shooting backstage at a boxing match inside the Barclays Center. But Melly wasn't present for too much of the drama. Actually, besides the occasional video, studio session, or photo shoot on the block, Melly wasn't playing 6ix9ine too close. It would come out later in wiretaps that Melly looked down on 6ix9ine and shunned him a few times when they first crossed paths in the beginning. His connection to 6ix9ine really came from his close relationship to Shoddy, who looked up to Melly as the big homie. Eventually, a power struggle for control of 6ix9ine and the money he brought in would break out between warring factions of the non-trade bloods. A kidnapping, beating, and robbery of Tekashi, along with many more brazen acts of violence, would have the feds breathing down their necks. Next, 6ix9ine would actually accuse Shoddy and other non-trade members of being disloyal and also stealing money from him. He would go on to do an interview on The Breakfast Club where he denounces affiliation with Treyway and the non-trade bloods. Over the next few days, the feds would start hearing threats to violate Tekashi on Melly's tap phone while he spoke to different non-trade members. Fearing for his safety, they would decide to release the indictment and charge 6ix9ine, Shoddy, Mel Murder, and multiple more Treyway members with racketeering and other charges. As the case played itself out in the courtroom, with Tekashi being a star witness, the evidence against Mel Murder would come to light. The feds would have Melly delivering a kilo of heroin to an undercover cop who was acting as a buyer. The deal was set up by Christian CEO Chris Cruz, a non-trade member who's directly linked to Melly and who also was a government informant. Mel Murder would be paid $10,000 for the deal and be arrested by the feds a couple days after. Rather than take it to trial and face way more time, Melly decided to cop out for his role in the indictment and was sentenced to 135 months in prison, which is a little over 11 years. He's currently serving his time in federal prison with a release date in June of 2028. But yo, it's What's the Numbers TV. This profile piece is on Jamel Jones, aka Mel Murder. I didn't want to go into the whole Tekashi situation too deep, or the shoddy or the Treyway. You know what I'm saying? I wanted to just focus on Melly, being that it isn't too much on him out there on the internet. So I wanted to do a video on him. That's what this profile piece is for. You know what I'm saying? It's What's the Numbers TV. Make sure you like, subscribe, share. Also, I want to touch on, it's kind of crazy how CEO Chris was able to line him up, basically put a whole deal together with the police, and then basically just call Melly up, like, yo, go deliver this to me. I got $10,000 for you. And, you know, get him off the streets like that. So the extent that certain people will go to save themselves, or even the authorities will go to a certain extent to get certain people off the street, is kind of crazy. But like I said, this profile piece is on Mel Murder. Hope y'all appreciate it. We are about to hit 26,000 subscribers. Thank all of y'all who subscribe. The 1 year anniversary from What's the Numbers is coming up May 26th. Go follow the Instagram. And it's your boy, Poe Rowe. What's the Numbers TV. We back before you know, man. We out of here. Peace.